The McDonald's is food you buckle in with your seatbelt deal. And there's no reason not to take that extra precaution. Because a meal from McDonald's is not just a meal. It's often your most precious cargo. Enjoy a tasty double cheeseburger or a six-piece chicken McNuggets for $2 each. Add any size soft drink like an ice-cold Dr. Pepper for just a dollar more. Price and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with combo meal.
Welcome to Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's Big Neighborhood. Boy. Thank you for being in the neighborhood. We got a whole lot more show coming up for you. All righty now, the last season of Narcos is coming. Yeah, it's going to be a crazy one.
Netflix finally dropped it. Season 3 of Narcos Mexico is going to be coming out, man. And I think it's going to be, you know, this is after some of the cartel members from the Guadalajara cartel got arrested. So now it's kind of like a free-for-all in Mexico. And we've kind of
be that next king.
And we've kind of seen that, bro. So I can only imagine what kind of hell is going to happen.
Man,
on this
I get
season.
Nervous when we start talking about things like that. So I'm not going to even watch it. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to even watch it, bro. My whole career, I've never said anything about the Mexican mafia. Believe that. All righty. So the last season of Narcos is coming. And here's what I do. Don't judge me.
All right. Don't judge me, guys. In order to even try to order pizza, I got to find a coupon code somewhere.
I really just have
to find a coupon code for something, bro.
Hey.
I can like sit there and like look for 45 minutes to find a coupon code. Then I'll order some pizza, bro.
Hey, man, I won't judge you on
don't
that,
judge
bro.
Don't judge me, dog.
And we want to hear yours, then. Too. Yeah, he does. He does.
Hell,
here's what
yeah.
I do. Don't judge me. We got that coming up. And also, is Jay-Z's empire getting even bigger? Is it getting even more bigger?
Even bigger. Big. He's a billionaire. He's got investments in like Uber. Mm. He, you know, is married to Beyonce. What else does this guy need in his life?
I don't know.
There is something he doesn't have.
Really, though.
And he wants it. I think he wants it.
Right.
I'm going to tell you what it is.
And he wants it. All righty, so we're going to see if Jay-Z's empire is getting even bigger. And also, in case you missed it, Ani, we got
T-Pain
up in here.
Vic, he talked about this tattoo he has on his right hand that I never noticed, but it's a Jackie Chan tattoo of Face of Jackie.
Yeah, man. I wonder if Jackie Chan got hit like a T-Pain tattoo on him.
I like got you a drink.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Y'all do stick around, y'all radios, all that, a lot more Big Boys
Big
Neighborhood.
Big laughs, big stars, big hip-hop hits. It's Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
This one right here, man, is where Luther calls to deliver a free paint job to someone. You know how when you're out and you get those like little vouchers where it's like, oh, you can win this, you can win that.
Yeah.
It's a contest. So we have a contest winner on here, and we're ready to go ahead and paint that apartment. This is going to get to your phone tap right here, Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
Hello, let me speak to
not in.
Could you leave a message?
Okay, shoot.
Tell him congratulations. She had filled out one of those little applications to get inside of a contest, and she was chosen as the grand prize winner to get the house painted.
Okay.
Yeah, did she tell you about this?
I had written one out, too.
Okay, well, we're going to send somebody by. We're just wondering what day should they come by to paint the apartment.
This is free, right?
The actual painting is free. The only thing that you would have to pay for is the paint per gallon. And there'll be a team of four painters there, and they work for $32 an hour.
And the painters?
Yes.
I didn't know we had to pay for the painters.
It'll probably be between $5,000 and $7,000.
You said everything was free.
I'm not here to argue with you. I was just calling to congratulate you guys.
You congratulating everybody or whatnot. We paying for the person to paint them up, and for the paint, you said you told me everything was free.
Everything is free.
And no, it's not what
yes,
I got
it
to
is.
Pay for the painters.
You sound real ruffled, like I made you upset. And I didn't mean to make your punk this upset.
You say you ain't mean to make my punk upset, huh?
Yeah.
Ain't that a yeah. You believe that,
baby? Well, you sound, baby. You sound like it.
You can't judge a person by their voice.
I'm going to come down there. You want some flowers?
You did get me upset, though.
And I'm sorry about that.
All right, no problem.
And I apologize.
Baby. Okay, I tell you what. Tomorrow and Thursday.
All right, so they're going to be buying on Saturday, and you guys owe us $7,000.
You crazy.
You're going to have four Latinos at your house on Saturday morning.
Clear that.
And if you don't pay them, they're going to whoop your ass if you don't pay them.
Phone taps on the tens. Every hour, every day. right here at Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Yep. Big Boy's Big Neighborhood, boy. Louis G up in here. Bad play of the day.
Bad play of the day, bro. And this goes to this company called Colossal. Why? Because they just got funded and they are on a mission within the next 6 years to re-extinct the woolly mammoth.
Ah.
So
to re-extinct?
Re-extinct.
So to make them gone again?
No, to bring them, I guess. That's what they called it. Re-extincted.
Isn't that de-extinct?
And now is it de-extinct or re-extinct?
What is it? Because re-extinct, wouldn't that be to like make him extinct again?
Oh, yeah, that's not right. No,
am I tripping, Jason?
Yeah, yeah, no, they want to bring it back.
So
within the next 6 years, they want to bring the woolly mammoth to
planet
Earth.
As usual, Louis is wrong.
Yeah. Hey, man, and then he do these things, Jason, and it makes me wonder if I'm correct.
Right?
You know what I'm saying? It's like he makes the whole room you know what I mean without sounding
Welcome
bad.
To my TED Talk, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, man.
But yo, think about it. Within the next 6 years, they want to bring a dinosaur back to life on planet Earth.
Might as well, man. Can
We've
you imagine?
Heard this movie before.
Hey, dude, can you imagine if we really had like a Jurassic Park?
Yo, not only that, one of the investors.
Like a real one, though.
No, Ani, yeah. It would not be cool.
What do you mean?
So many people die in Jurassic Park. They'll this is friend. Not a good idea.
Have you not seen Jurassic Park where the kids are in the car and the T-Rex just rolls up?
That's a movie, you guys.
Yeah,
you're
it is a movie.
Stop.
So if they brought back humans, all the humans would be murderers.
Yeah. Who wants a T-Rex on the loose, bro?
I do.
No, I've seen Jurassic Park too many times.
Hey,
I know
man.
This story.
If Larry Elder could become damn near the governor of California, we could definitely get a T-Rex back up.
No, man, this is horrible. One of the people behind it is somebody that worked on Jurassic Park World.
Yeah.
Like, dude, how many investors are going to want to do this and try to bring these dinosaurs to life?
Dude, if they could bring dinosaurs back in 6 years.
Yeah.
That means that there's a technology or they got the wherewithal to do so many other things.
DNA mapping, mix animals with other animals, create different animals.
Uh-huh.
I'm telling you, dog, it's like DNA re-engineering.
Yeah, man. What was that movie where they had the little monkeys in the lab and the monkeys went crazy?
You remember Planet of the Apes?
No, not Planet of the Apes. It was something else. But it was like little monkeys, and these little monkeys were like little gangsters, and they put them in. Yeah.
Wait, what?
Yeah, it was like crazy,
I
man.
I want to see this movie.
Yeah, yeah. I think it was called like Little Monkey Gangsters or something like that.
Little monkey gangsters, but
yeah, but they were like in a lab. Jace, do you remember this movie I'm speaking about? They were like in a lab.
Well, there was the Bruce Willis movie. It was like 12 monkeys.
12 monkeys.
Oh, yeah. It was probably
Dustin
that.
Hoffman.
That was it.
Disease?
Thank you, Jason.
Oh, Outbreak?
Oh, that was Outbreak.
That was it.
That was one little crazy monkey.
Yeah, they were like
that
little gangster monkeys.
Yeah,
like,
what's that? Blue? What up, girl? You want the disease? What's
yeah,
up?
Yeah, yeah.
I got it right here.
Tear this whole place up. Get me out of this cage.
But if this really happens, I'm pretty sure Disneyland's going to be the first one to have this like dinosaur park.
All righty. Y'all do stick around. Y'all radios, Big Boy's Neighborhood.
You're waking up to Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
Ani's up in here. What up, Ani?
What up, Big?
Oh, nothing. What we got?
New music.
New music. All righty.
And this is for the NFL season. Big Too Short got with Ice Cube, and then he also reached out to Neo. He was like, Neo, you got to jump on this because Vegas raised you. But they dropped a song for the Raider called Raider Colors.
Oakland, California, all the way through Nevada. Yeah. We in them Raider colors, them dark fader colors. You always in them hater colors. I bet you scared of the dark, scared of these Raider fans moving like sharks. Blood in the water, about to make a killing. Make them walk the plank, I'm dressed like a villain.
I'm just saying I bleed silver. If you cut me, I don't need no painkiller. It's all silver and black, we could win or lose. Went to 4 Super Bowls, we done paid our dues. It's Raider Nation, yeah we moved to Vegas, y'all. But you know this song ain't about football. You know where we from.
Black, everything silver. Black, everything come through. Smash, everything on everything.
Hey man, what's that song? I'll do anything. Yes, anything. For
that
you.
Sounds so familiar to me. I want to shazam you right now.
Hey man, that's a hell of a song though,
hell
man.
Yeah,
I'm definitely
man.
Not gonna be playing it in my car though. Not because I'm not a Raiders fan. It just sounds cheesy to me. I ain't gonna lie to you guys.
It does, but it's so cool. But well, I was surprised that Neo was on there because I was like, wait, why is Neo on here?
Yeah, Neo is Vegas though.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
Big.
Yeah.
I thought he was just probably from the East Coast, probably. But then when I saw this, he did an interview with Too Short on IG Live, and Too Short was just like, thank you for jumping sang on this song.
Now, I know that Cube is Raider Nation. Oh, for real, for real. I didn't know that Too Short was, though.
I didn't either. He said, well, they started off in Oakland. I was a fan here.
Ah, gotcha, gotcha. Oh, yeah, definitely. That's low-hanging fruit.
But I just thought it was so... And Big, they said that the NFL season at the Raiders stadium, they just had the fans for the first time come in there, and it was
that
so
game
wild.
Was thunderous.
Yes, man.
Did
that
you guys
Raider
watch?
Game... No, I'm just saying it. She said, did you guys watch? Wait till you see next week's game. It's even more thunderous. Nah, that game was thunderous. It was a great game. The crowd was amazing,
they
man. They went into
Vegas
overtime.
Down.
Yeah, they did that right. That was a hell of a way to make sure that fans had their first, like, real enjoyment of a Raider game there.
That is so cool. You guys, I was reading about it, and people were like, this is the game you don't take your kids to because everyone's just going crazy. It's so fun. They're like, you barely saw any kids, and if you did, they were just awkwardly standing there.
Yeah, man, watching their parents fight. You know what I'm saying? Y'all stick around. Y'all radios, Big Boy's Neighborhood.
You're checking out Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
Natalia's up in here. Survey says...
Survey says...
Survey says what, Natalia?
It says that people are cheating at work.
Oh,
a lot.
Really though?
Okay, so Big, as you know... We all went through it. The pandemic.
Yes,
so many of us were sent home at one point to work from home. I know still a lot of people working from home. And so obviously that changes your routines, the people you see while you're at work. Well, now they're saying that an increasing amount of people are going back to work specifically this month in September, and that they are getting ready to cheat.
Oh, really?
Gosh, it
says, I haven't seen you.
It says that this dating site that did this survey says there is a surge in workplace romances this month, and that it says 78% of people believe that working back at the office would make it easier to cheat with a colleague.
Hey, man, I remember a trainer I used to go to. Mm-hmm. Man, we used to see a couple pull up, and they would get in the guy's van during lunch and do what they had to do.
Oh.
And we'd just stand there and look like, oh, they're back. And then they're getting their separate cars, and then they'll leave.
I mean, it happens because when you think about where you spend most of your time, you spend it at work. I see you guys way more than I see my family.
I was about to say that.
See?
Yep.
That's true.
And so, yeah, sometimes you do get around someone that maybe you guys just click. You always hear that term, oh, that's my work husband or that's my work wife. Mm-hmm. But sometimes people cross those lines.
Do you have a work husband?
No.
No, I'm just wondering. I'm just wondering.
Juan be trying to, you know, hey, Louis, can you grab this? Can you hold this? Can you help me out with this? For no reason.
Yeah.
Things that he can do by himself.
Oh,
so.
Big, I dropped that. Can you pick it up? All right, Juan.
He hits on me sometimes.
Yeah.
But it is saying that there's going to be a rise now that people are going
Who
back
to could you
to
have
work.
A work husband?
Maybe.
Nah, don't say it because I'm... Because I got the power of the contract.
I know.
I wonder... Who would your work husband be? Maybe this is awkward.
Yeah, this is kind of awkward, Doug.
Yeah, maybe this is awkward. Yeah, I never really had like a work wife.
Yeah.
Like, I never referred to, oh, that's like my work wife.
Yeah, neither have I.
I hope Myra doesn't have like a work husband.
She does.
Hate it.
Go ahead, Nathalia.
Oh, come on, man.
Come on, man. She's got to fantasize a little bit. Look at you. You know what I'm saying? Come on, give her that, dude. Give her some kind of license.
So now that people are headed back to the office, I feel like people like... They're going to start seeing a member. They're going to be like, oh, I remember him.
Yeah, get some real work done, huh? Mm-hmm. All righty, y'all stick around. Y'all radios, Big Boy's Neighborhood.
You're in Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's Neighborhood, give it up for Ani! Ani is up in here. Click of the day, Ani.
Big, there is this psychic on TikTok.
Oh, man. I don't mess with psychics, but go ahead.
Oh, my gosh. This psychic, Big, he apparently can really tell the future. So many people believe in him. Right now, he quit his job. He had, like, this 9-to-5 job where he was a therapist, and he was like, nope, my TikTok needs me. I need to get on there and read
I heard that. He must be making more money. Go ahead.
He's definitely making more money. And then, Big, this is kind of like the little advices he'll give on his TikTok.
I'm Kaylin, I'm a psychic. Spirit wants to remind you not to lower any of your expectations of the kind of person you want to fall in love with. I also see love coming within the next 8 months. Got it?
Love is coming in within the next 8 months. God. That could be a long time.
Yeah.
Wow. Anything that you see, you're going to think is love.
Yeah.
Hey, man, they used to, back in the days, they used to say there was one born every minute. Now it seems like there's one born, sucker born every minute. Now it's one every second. Like, there's a sucker born. Like, if he's large on TikTok, that means a lot of suckers out there.
Big, apparently, he has over 24,000 clients right now. And then I was going through his TikTok because I was like, you know, Big will tell me, like, Ani, not everything you see on TikTok is real. So I'm like reading through the comments and stuff. People really go to him. They're like, man, I can't believe you charged me $300. Like, yeah, you told me what my future, whatever it was. But this is a ripoff. You're supposed to be a spiritual guidance.
Oh, people said that in his comments?
And then he replied back to it, like, in a video where
he
could
said, you're going to die in 2 days. I would have told him as this psychic and spiritual advisor, I would have like, hey, if you put anything else on my screen, bad things will happen to you before Christmas.
That would be smart.
And then I'll say, try me.
The big one person who doesn't believe him is his sister.
Oh, yeah.
She's like, I just don't believe in things
she hip to the garbage.
Hell yeah.
She was there when they did the intervention. You know what I'm saying? When they tried to get them off drugs. But go ahead.
The big, this made me think of, like, is there anything that you've ever, whether it's, to me, it's been ghosts, right? I've seen my brothers like, you're crazy. There's no such thing as ghosts. But have you ever seen anything or had special powers where?
No, my sister has, like, dreams.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, I was telling y'all how my sister has dreams. You know what I'm saying? I've seen and bear witness to ghosts. I've seen my mom. You know what I'm saying? So images. So I believe. You ever been to a psychic?
Me, yeah.
Yeah, really?
And it happened.
You're all happy?
Yeah,
well,
I know.
I had to go because I thought something really bad was going to happen to my family. So I had to go and I had to know. And the psychic like made me completely calm down.
That's
and she's
good,
like,
man. Was that when your mom was going through her cancer battle? That's beautiful. I'm glad she told you something that calmed you down, too.
It really, I would cry. So I was so happy.
Oh, that's beautiful. Y'all stick around. Y'all radios, Big Boy's Neighborhood.
This is Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's Neighborhood. Louis G up in here. What up, Ludo?
Yo, football superstar Cristiano Ronaldo. Everyone knows him. He's one of the most popular people on Instagram. The dude is a millionaire.
Many times over.
Yeah, many times over, man. But yeah, he just recently went back to Manchester United, his old team that he was playing with for so many years. But now they're saying that since he's in a new team, he's bringing this new energy, and some of the teammates are noticing and kind of pushing back on certain things. One of those things is eating dessert in front of Cristiano Ronaldo.
Really, though?
Because they're afraid that he's going to judge these players for not having the same diet as him. If you don't know about Cristiano Ronaldo's diet, there was one teammate that mentioned something on a podcast, and this is what he said when he invited him to lunch.
When Cristiano invites you for lunch at his house, just say no. He once said, Patrice, come over after training. I went. You know, I was really tired. At the table, there was only salad and plain white chicken. So I was like, okay. And water, not any juice. We started eating and I was thinking some big meat would be coming after that, but there was nothing. He just finished and he stood up and started playing with a ball, doing some skills.
Damn.
Do you really want to go to Cristiano Ronaldo's house and eat nothing but, you know, veggies and little chicken and water?
Don't judge him for how he eats either.
That's very true.
You know what I'm saying? You don't want to eat desserts or eat snacks in front of him.
Yeah, but they're saying,
you're afraid.
They're saying that some of his teammates don't even dare to eat some type of dessert in front of Cristiano Ronaldo.
Don't judge me.
Yeah, dog. I can see that, but man, imagine the little, what they're doing now. They're probably eating something before they go into the practice facility.
Is there anything that you do that you'll say, here's what I do, don't judge me?
Don't judge me. Like I said, I have a certain spoon at home that I have to use or else I won't like start eating.
Right.
Don't judge me. Sorry, I know it's a little kid thing, but it's just my spoon, okay? It's mine.
It's very possessive.
But
this
don't
food.
Judge him. Jesus Christ,
okay.
Natalia.
Don't judge me, but when I order chicken wings for the house, I have to have my own box. And then I'll order a second if anyone else wants more.
Why is that? Oh, my God.
What? Don't judge me.
You judge him.
I know, sorry. Don't judge me.
So you got to have your own box.
My own box of chicken wings.
And then everybody else.
I'll always ask, be like, does anyone else want wings? And if someone says yes, I'll order two boxes.
Right.
Yep.
My thing is, man, like I told y'all, when I get dressed, I put my shoes on first, and then I put my shorts on.
How does it go?
You know, I don't wear these tight ass shorts like how you wear them. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about like.
He doesn't wear Daisy Duke.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Come on, baby. Get those Daisy. Look at Louis on Daisy Duke song.
I will judge you, dog.
Yeah, here's what no I judgments. Do. Don't judge me. And I won't judge you for wearing Daisy Dukes. Here's what I do. Don't judge me. Hit us up 866-246-8923. Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
You're in Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's Neighborhood. Here's what I do. Don't judge me.
Don't judge me.
All righty, let's bring Bree into the neighborhood. Bree, hello.
Hello.
Hello there, Bree. Bree, here's what I do. Don't judge me.
Never.
Wait, say it again.
Oh, I'm sorry. I think you said for me I was to judge you. I'm so sorry. I would never judge you, babe. Sorry.
No. I'll just throw back the segment title to you. All right. She was listening to like, Big, I'll never judge you. You know, sometimes you say stupid stuff, but I keep that to myself. You know what I'm saying? I keep that to myself. Yeah. Oh, I love it. Oh, thank you, Bree. Bree, but here's what I do. Don't judge me.
This is why I do. Don't judge me. So I believe in manifestation and positive affirmation. So I don't care where I'm at or who I'm with. If I'm feeling down or like I'm down on my luck, I will speak it out into the universe.
I heard that. I love that, man. Liz, that used to work with me. Liz is really big on that as well.
She is.
You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I tell her, like, hey, get off your high horse. Life is crazy. That's what I tell her. I heard that.
I'm telling you, it works. You speak it out into the universe, and it just has a way of coming true. It's a law of attraction. You got to believe it. You got to really, really believe that it's achievable. And it will happen.
I heard that. Yeah. Here's what I do. Don't judge me. Hit us up. 866-246-8923. 866-246-8923. Let's bring Gina into the neighborhood. Gina, hello. Gina, hello.
Hello.
Hello there, Gina. Gina, here's what I do. Don't judge me.
Ever since I was little, I always separate my food and keep it separate, and I don't mix it. I eat one item at a time.
Wow. So you don't, like, you wouldn't eat a piece of chicken and, like, mashed potatoes and have that in your mouth at the same time?
No, that's nasty to me.
Wow. Hey, don't judge us. Don't judge us. Now, Gina, you judging everybody else that don't do that. My brother Mouse, Gina, he was kind of the same way. He didn't like his food to touch.
Really?
Yeah, man. Yeah, and then there's some people. Hey, Gina, do you eat and drink at the same time, or you eat first?
I'll eat first.
Wow. So everything you eat separately, you eat your hamburger, then your fries. Like, how would you eat like a combo?
My hamburger and then my fries.
I heard that.
Wow.
Hey, right. Stop all the wowing and all. We're not judging people today. All right. Here's what I do. Don't judge me. Hit us up, 866-246-8923. Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Check this out.
Hey, it is your partner, Big Boy, from Big Boy's Neighborhood on iHeartRadio. Here's another in case you missed it moment with us. Don't try this at home, Ani.
Don't ban men from working. This is what's going on in Australia. If any man wants to be a street sweeper, they cannot be a street sweeper. They're saying the only requirement is this.
You must identify as non-male, i.e. female, non-binary, or gender non-conforming.
Right now, there's a lot of men in the street sweeping industry, and they're like, you know what? We want to make sure that women get in here so they can work, too.
I'm pretty sure that there's a lot of ladies that can drive a street cleaner.
Yeah,
so I was like, but why are you going to exclude the men? That kind of sucks. And I was like, we should start, you know, excluding other stuff, maybe.
Like what?
Well, I was thinking stripping, because I never really go to, a lady strip club or a guy strip club, and
you're
I see
saying,
them.
You're saying, wait, what? Stop strippers? Like, male and female, or?
No, they should be together, kind of. Like, instead
like in
of
the
just
same club?
Oh, no. That could be the
All right. Give it up for Cinnamon right there. Give it up for Cinnamon. Now coming to the stage. Give it up for King Lamar.
Yeah. No, that ain't going to happen. Thank you for listening. It is your partner, Big Boy, Big Boy's Neighborhood. You can catch more of us right here on iHeartRadio.
Give it up for King
Lamar. Yeah. Real nice.
The McDonald's is food you buckle in with your seatbelt deal. And there's no reason not to take that extra precaution. Because a meal from McDonald's is not just a meal. It's often your most precious cargo. Enjoy a tasty double cheeseburger or a six-piece chicken McNuggets for $2 each at any size soft drink like an ice-cold Dr. Pepper for just a dollar more. Price and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with combo meal.
Did you know that September 25th is National Tune-Up Day? Well, it is, and Service Experts is celebrating with wishes. That means for every tune-up they perform in the month of September, they'll make a $5 contribution to Make-A-Wish, up to $20,000 to help them on their mission to create life-changing wishes for children with critical illnesses. Want to do National Tune-Up Day right? There's an expert for that. Make a wish come true today and schedule your tune-up today at serviceexperts.com.
823, LA's new home for hip hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boys Neighborhood, beautiful day in the neighborhood. Y'all continue to hang out with us up in here, man. It's about that time for your 810 phone tap. Dookie Chase.
Yeah.
This one right here, man, is when Luther calls a soul food restaurant. He calls back to a soul food restaurant to confess that he ate a meal and he didn't pay for the meal. He just walked out, you know, and more than a full stomach, he also took the hot sauce as well. Hey, don't feel, hey, yeah, no, she was talking about bodily harm in his phone tap. Yeah, this is gangster granny in this one. Let's go to get into your phone tap on the tens right here, Big Boys Big Neighborhood. Boy.
My name is Luther. I was there. It doesn't matter what I have, but I had up to close to $30 worth of food.
Uh-huh.
I walked out without paying for the food.
Well, that's not nice.
And now I'm kind of feeling bad now, coming down and eating all that delicious soul food and not paying for it.
Well, will you be coming back in my area to pay me for it?
I'll be coming back, but not to pay for it, no.
You know, every once in a while we get stuck and we don't forget a face, and I can easily go roll back that camera and see who didn't pay. And the next time you come through the door, I'll break your leg.
So you saying that I did wrong by not paying, but you're right for causing me bodily harm?
Why would you just walk out of an establishment without paying?
You know, I was sitting there, and once I finish, and I go through like a series of belches that I do. And after my last belch, I sat down, I looked around, and I said, you know what, you can walk out of this place right now. And so I did. And I was out of there. So what should I do? What's your name, Gertrude?
No, my name's not Gertrude.
The person has to pay for the food, right?
Oh, they definitely will have to pay the
Okay, so could you tell the person thank you for me?
Oh, I'm sure they'll look for you. I hope they don't cross you in the street somewhere.
Why?
Because what they may do to you is not my responsibility.
They're going to be even madder because I took the tip jar with me also.
Now, if you were person enough to come back.
Where do you guys get that hot sauce from?
I pay for it.
Do you guys charge per bottle or per container for that?
No, for you, I wouldn't try to sell you one.
Well, I took one.
Like I said, if you're a criminal and you feel you can.
I'm not a criminal, ma'am.
You want me to believe that?
So if, okay, today.
Stole my hot sauce.
Yeah, yes, I did steal your hot sauce.
Food and you walked out.
Yes, I did eat your food and I walked out. And I stole some forks.
That tells me you're just a natural born thief then, huh?
The napkin holder, tablecloth.
You do what you have to do.
Well, I'm not going to come back down.
Phone taps on the tens every hour, every day, right here at Big Boys Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boys Neighborhood, here's what I do, don't judge me. Here's what I do, don't judge me. Let's bring Totsy into the neighborhood. Totsy, hello.
Hello.
Totsy, all righty now, here's what I do, don't judge me.
Okay, wherever I go to eat, no matter where it is, I have to ask for plasticware. Now, sometimes it could be kind of weird if we're somewhere really fancy, but I have to ask for plasticware.
Damn, that's crazy. And, you know, I was about to kind of say the same thing. Why do you ask for plasticware?
It's weird because it gives me the same sensation as, you know, when people put their nails on, like, chalk, like in movies. It makes me feel that way.
When you eat with regular
with
utensils,
yeah,
like with
but,
silverware?
But only when I'm not at home, because I could do it at home. I just can't do it when I'm out.
Wow. Oh. Hey, don't judge her.
I'm not.
Let me tell you what's crazy, yeah. Totsy, okay. Is I eat with plastic spoons, plastic forks, and plastic mm-hmm. knives, right? But that comes from, like, when we were homeless, mm-hmm. we didn't have, you know, silverware.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we ate out of a lot of, like, plastic. Yeah. And if you go to my house now, we went to Costco yesterday. It's, you know, we got beautiful dishware. Mm-hmm. But I have all kind of plastic plates, plastic cups,
plastic forks, you know what I'm saying?
Ready to go.
Yeah.
And you know what I think about how when they get washed, maybe they just soak them. I don't know. It just makes me feel like they're not washing them right sometimes. So
you can could be at Shea and you'll get plastic forks.
Yeah, that's just what I do.
Hey, dude, I carry plastic forks with me. Like, I have a bag my car with, yeah.
We could eat together then.
Oh, wait, hold on. Let me call Veronica. Hold on.
I know. I'm trying to ask you out.
I'm going
to
put you on hold, Totsie. Let me call the queen real quick. All righty, let me see here. I'll wait.
Her number.
Oh, damn. Oh, yeah. You got a number?
I got a number.
All right, we'll make it happen. All righty. Here's what I do. Don't judge me. Let's bring Guillermo into the neighborhood. Guillermo, hello.
Hello.
Hello there, Guillermo. Here's what I do. Don't judge me.
Oh, man. Don't judge me, Big. But I have two little boys. And every now and then they get sick. And they get all stuffed up with boogers.
Hey, man, your phone is sounding crazy. Pull away from your phone just a little bit. You say you have two little boys?
Yeah, I have two little boys, and they get all stuffy and runny, and they have all types of boogers and stuff like that. So what I would do is I would suck the snot right out of their nose without anything, just like my mouth. And everyone would just look at me, and they'd be like, oh, man, that's disgusting.
Hey, man, let me tell you, Guillermo. Let me tell you. My wife still trips off of this because I did that with my kids.
Really?
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, you know how you got them little things in it? Like,
the
suckers. Like, your kids,
yeah.
Man, I couldn't watch my kids suffer. Aww. They didn't know how to go. So I would literally take my mouth and put it over their nose and suck it out and spit it out. Aww. Yeah, but you know, look a certain way. That's
Louis
love.
Louis doesn't want kids.
Say what now?
Louis doesn't want kids.
Nah, that is. Hey, man, let me tell you.
It's love.
You don't have kids.
Yeah.
You know, I can't even say that because even people with kids be like, oh, no, I can't do that. Yeah, I can't. I'm like, man. But you know what? Sit up and watch your kids suffer. Sit up and watch your kids suffer. You know what I'm saying? People do that to their cat.
Wow.
Yeah. And their dog. You know what I'm saying?
True, Doug.
Y'all hit us up 866-246-8923. Big Boys Big Neighborhood.
Boy. You're checking out Big Boys Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boys Big Neighborhood. Boy. Yes, we're standing up against racism. Yeah. Standing up against racism. Now, Nathalia was just talking to Ani. She leaned over and she said, do you know a guy named Paul from Tarzana? He's Russian Armenian as well. And I was like, does she supposed to know all Russian Armenians?
Ani tells me she knows all Armenians all the time. And I thought that since he's from the valley and that they both are Russian Armenian, I was like, how crazy would it be if they did know each other? So I was like, I might as well ask.
Hey, babe, do you know Steve? He's black. Oh, let me see. Steve.
No, this was like
Steve
more specific.
From like West LA.
But Ani said,
I just said that most Armenians end up knowing each other, so like I'm probably really related to Paul somehow.
No, you're not. Don't.
If it turns out that they know each other,
first we got Larry Elder trying to be the governor.
No.
Now we got this. You know what I'm saying? This is a big one as an Armenian.
Unbelievable, Natalia. Unbelievable, you would bring this.
That journey. I didn't ask you.
Hey, man.
You asked me off air yesterday.
You know what? Okay. You know what? This is a don't judge me segment.
Yes. You're right.
Don't judge her. She was just asking a question.
Unbelievable.
It off of previous conversations that I've had with Ani, I thought maybe. You never know.
Right. Okay. All right. So, Jason, I'll still take a call. Just leave it there. All right. Let's do this. Let's drop the here's what I do. Don't judge me. Yeah. Let's go into who in the neighborhood is the most racist.
Exactly. Louis, do you know any short people in Anaheim about your size?
Yeah.
It's not about you, Louis.
Hey, man, we were on a good road till he said that. It wasn't even funny. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, I can't judge him. Let's bring Evelyn. Let's bring Evelyn into the neighborhood. Evelyn, hello.
Hello
there. Evelyn, are you black?
No.
Oh, okay. I was just wondering. Now, Evelyn, here's what I do. Don't judge me, Evelyn.
Okay, here's what I do. Don't judge me. So whether I'm driving at the store, at church, the market, whatever, if someone bends over, I make a fart sound with my mouth.
Oh. Hey, Evelyn. Evelyn, like even when you drive a Biden, you just go.
Yes, I swear.
Oh.
Like I'll be driving and like I'm at the stoplight or whatever, and someone's gonna walk across the street and they'll bend against something. And I'll be like.
single time.
Oh my God, Evelyn, that is hilarious.
That's too funny.
Hey, dude, why do I know I'm going
to
do
it to my coworkers in front of our boss one time, and I totally forgot she was right there.
Oh, how long have you been doing that? How long you been doing that, Evelyn?
Honestly, for like 10 years. Maybe.
Oh man, I love it. It's on hey, auto. Dude, I know I'm going to do it today. You know what I'm saying?
It never gets old.
Yeah. Have you ever done it at a funeral when somebody kisses someone goodbye? Be like. Now I'm wrong, Day-Day. Now I'm wrong. All right, don't judge me, Day-Day.
Yes, Day-Day, judge me. Stop judging us.
It's a judge-free zone. All righty, what's Big Boy's Neighborhood?
You're waking up to Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's Big Neighborhood. Boy. Natalia's up in here. Natalia, let's do this one.
Big, yesterday we had this conversation that we were going on with, like, who or what gets in the way of your relationship, and living rent-free right now in my brain is this anonymous caller.
Yeah, man.
So currently I'm in a situation where, you know, a coworker is like texting my boyfriend.
Like, what does he say about the text messages that he's getting from his coworkers? Is it work related?
Yeah, he thinks it's work related, that they're just really good friends. And I'm like, okay, can I, like, should I believe him or not?
Wow. Does he even show you the text?
No, he erased everything.
He erases the work text?
Stop it.
Yeah, so
he's erasing, like, you know, hey, did you leave your fob here, or, you know, there's a folder on your desk. He erases just regular work texts.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's kind of, you know, it's iffy. Like, I'm iffy about it.
And that's just a piece of it, you guys. She was talking about it happens all night. You know what I'm saying? So, people called us up when we got her off the phone.
So many people had opinions of, like, wanting to give her advice. Other people had, like, oh, I was in a similar situation.
Right.
So, like, I just couldn't stop thinking about it.
Yeah, so just listening to that call right there. And it was, her name was Anonymous. And Anonymous, if you're listening right now, we would love for you to call us back, because we got a lot of calls. You know what I'm saying? But people just saying, this is what's going down. Mm-hmm. This is what's going down. What do you think is happening there?
Oh, my goodness. I think he's...
It's nothing innocent.
It's obvious.
No, it's not that obvious.
Yes,
I mean, I think he's, like, I think if he hasn't cheated, he might cheat.
Right.
Like, on the verge. Like, he's building a relationship with that coworker.
And I just want to hear from you guys out there as well. You heard the caller, Anonymous, that hit us up yesterday. What do you think is happening there?
Yeah.
All righty. And if you have a story of your own, I'd love to hear that, too. But what do you think is happening? Y'all hit us up, 866-246-8923, Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Welcome to Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities, Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Now, yesterday we got a call from one of our neighbors, right? Mm-hmm. And what was the topic yesterday that we were talking about?
Who or what is getting in the way of your relationship?
Who or what is getting in the way of your relationship? And this is just a piece of what she said.
So currently I'm in a situation where, you know, a coworker is like texting my boyfriend.
Like, what does he say about the text messages that he's getting from his coworkers? Is it work related?
Yeah, he thinks it's work related, that they're just really good friends. And I'm like, okay, can I, like, should I believe him or not?
Wow. Does he even show you the text?
No, he erased everything.
He erases the work text?
Stop it.
So
he's erasing, like, you know, hey, did you leave your fob here, or, you know, there's a folder on your desk? He erases just regular work text?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, that's kind of, you know, it's iffy. Like, I'm iffy about it.
All righty. So we ask you to listen to that caller. And Anonymous is, she called up under Anonymous. And I would love for her to call us back. We didn't get her information. But what is happening here? Alrighty, we ask you to hit us up, 866-246-8923. We'll bring another Anonymous into the neighborhood. Alrighty now, Anonymous, hello. Anonymous, hello. Anonymous, what do you think is happening there when you listen to that phone call?
Big, I think that she is, either one, she doesn't want to admit what's going on, but most definitely, to put it as nice as possible, I think he is definitely smashing his coworker. She doesn't want to admit it, even just the way she says it, that there's a girl texting her man. No, her man is also texting that coworker.
Yeah.
Her man is also giving her that time of day. What, I mean, what's next, Big? What's he going to say? Hey, we got a meeting at the Momo. I got to go.
Yeah.
For real.
Yeah, man. We have a group conference over at the motel.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. What do you think is happening there? Hit us up, 866-246-8923. That's 866-246-8923. Let's bring E into the neighborhood. Anonymous E, what's going on here? What are they hiding from? E, hello.
Hello.
Hello there, E. E, you heard the caller that we played, man. What do you think is happening there?
Hey, man. Honestly, Big, who's to say that she's not using or he's not using his coworker to propose to his girl? You know what I'm saying? Maybe he needs to get more in-depth information about women so he can do it right. You know what I'm saying? I don't necessarily say he's cheating. You can't just beat him down because, you know, maybe he don't want her to know. If she find out, that's going to spoil the surprise.
Hey, E, you cheating right now, huh?
Hey, check it out, Big Boy. Don't throw me under the bus.
Hey, man. So, E, maybe... He can't stop laughing. So E, maybe he's talking to his coworker about, you know, she's female and how to propose to his girl.
Yeah, he could be getting valuable information that most of us men don't know about women.
I heard that, man.
I'm just saying, man. You can't just necessarily say he cheated.
Yeah, that's true.
Especially at 2 in the morning.
Hey, man.
You get that text, you know?
Or you know what? Maybe he's talking to her.
Maybe she was on the internet searching something at 2 in the morning and found it. It was like, hey, check this out. Try this.
Oh, yeah.
What do you think about this?
You know what
I'm saying?
We definitely see what you're saying. Yeah. That could be true.
Yeah.
There it is right there. All righty. I know people going to call today, and we're going to have to run another segment tomorrow about E. Y'all hit us up, Big Boys Neighborhood.
Big laughs, big stars, big hip-hop hits. It's Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's
big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
Ani's up in here. What up, Ani?
What up, Big?
Oh, nothing. In case you missed it, who we got?
T-Pain,
my brother.
Did an interview, and during this interview, he talked about he has about 12 tattoos, and his tattoos are pretty random. One of them just says tattoo. The other one says you don't.
Hey, man, I always said that. I'm going to get a tattoo that says tattoo.
And T-Pain did it. But one of the other tattoos that he has, it's one on his hand, and it's a meme of Jackie Chan, and it's that meme we've all seen. It's been around for almost 10 years. It's Jackie Chan pulling his hair like, what are you talking about?
Hands at his head like,
And he even talked about it. He's like, the reason I got that is because I'll hold it up and people just know to shut up. Like, I don't have to say.
And the way that it's placed on his hand, if he holds it up, it's upright.
Oh, how
you
funny.
Know what I'm saying? Yeah.
And then,
I wonder if Jackie Chan got a T-Pain tattoo.
That would be so cool.
He doesn't, but
probably tattoo inception. I love it.
But Big, one of the times that T-Pain was in the neighborhood, we asked like, hey, what is it that you don't like about social media?
I don't like the stigma that comes from social media. You know what I don't like? I don't like the fact that, quote unquote,
Celebrities
can't say what everybody else says. I don't like that fact. I don't like the whole you can tell me to kill myself, but if I say something back. then it's
for sure.
Oh, that's offensive.
Do you block people? Like, I tell people, man, my block is hot.
Let me tell you my block game. I literally post something on Instagram, and then anybody that's offering to make me a logo or some graphic design, you're getting reported as a scam or spam.
I'm talking about
I will go through the entire
process.
Oh, bro. It is a well sought after process.
I will show up.
I will come to your and I will swipe. And I will report you as spam or a scam.
You're right. Hey, man, what about the ones that say, man, I'm just trying to get on like how you got on?
My dude, nope. Not. You know what? If they do that, I'll leave it there. But if you hit me with I know this isn't going to be seen, but I'm a 21-year-old.
Oh,
rapper.
Oh, my God.
You reported as a scam?
I've seen that,
or
man.
Spam.
Dude, I have seen that. Yeah. I know this is not going to be seen, but oh, my gosh. What I get also is, you know, do you want to get verified? I'm like, you're not verified.
Yeah.
Or you get the ones that say, increase your followers. And I'm like, you need to increase your followers.
Yeah.
Like, what are you talking about?
So many of those.
Man, I love T-Pain in the neighborhood, man. If you missed any of that interview, in case you missed, you can find the entire interview at RadioBigBoy.com.
Check this out.
Hey, did you find a Big Boy from Big Boy's Neighborhood on iHeartRadio?
Here's another in case you missed it moment with us.
The 2,701st star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Hollywood honors Big Boy. Big Boy.
please welcome to the stage comedian and Walk of Famer George Lopez.
There's nobody that I hold closer in my heart than I do Big Boy. When I first met him and I noticed that he had something on his arm and it said Ida's son, I can say as my brother that Ida is shining down and sending her love and her spirit to you and your family and to all your friends, Big Boy. And nobody means more to all the people who listen to radio all over the world, armed forces included. Que viva Big Boy, and welcome to the most famous street in the world, Big Boy!
Thank you for listening. It is your partner, Big Boy, Big Boy's Neighborhood. You can catch more of us right here on iHeartRadio.
iHeart, Big Boy.
Big Boy's Neighborhood!
The McDonald's is food you buckle in with your seatbelt deal. And there's no reason not to take that extra precaution. Because a meal from McDonald's is not just a meal. It's often your most precious cargo. Enjoy a tasty double cheeseburger or a six-piece chicken McNuggets for $2 each at any size soft drink like an ice-cold Dr. Pepper for just a dollar more. Price and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with combo meal.
Mohammed from Williamsville started at Geico in 2007. 10 promotions later, he's a high-level manager in the claims department.
When I first came to Geico, I thought to myself, you know, just a job, and I'll look for my career in my business management. And then I just kept getting promoted one after another, and I just realized that this could be my career. And obviously it is. There's a pretty good map on how to become a supervisor, on how to become a manager, on how to become whatever you would like to become.
Apply online at geico.jobs/buffalo.
92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's Big Neighborhood, boy. Natalia's up in here. Once again, Drake is in the neighborhood news.
He is, and he's in a position, Big, that he is all too familiar with, and that is on top. Mm-hmm. The breaking the records and all these things keep coming in. Right now, his song with Future and Young Thug, A Way Too Sexy, which the video is so dope, that's number one on the Billboard Hot 100.
Okay, all right, that's fine. Okay, I'm feeling too sexy to accept requests. Way too sexy. And I'm way too sexy to go unprotected. Way too sexy. And she popped a Tesla, now she gonna let you. Okay, all right.
Damn, that
such
dude.
A banger, but bro. That is not the only track, man, from Certified Lover Boy that is in the top 10.
Do you know this
10.
Story, Lou?
Okay, listen, just in the top 10, Billboard Hot 100, this is like the big chart to be a part of. In the top 10, he has 9 tracks in the top 10.
9 out of 10. Stop.
9 out of 10.
The top 10 is Drake.
Yes.
That's crazy, bro. First, I saw that. I was like, what the hell?
Right. It says that he's become the first artist to ever claim as many as 9 in the top 10 positions in a single frame. Isn't that
damn
crazy?
Who's that one? That's just
no,
up there.
No, he's Kid Leroy. Or,
no.
Is it Justin Bieber and someone?
Kanye West.
Oh, really?
Kanye
I
has.
I saw a different shot then.
Oh, the last one that I saw Kanye West, a Hurricane.
Are you looking at it right
all
now?
All right, hold on. Fact check, guys. So I'm looking at the thing right now. It says the Kid Leroy and Justin Bieber stay.
Yeah.
Is the only one out there in that top 10.
Okay, because yes. I thought when I did see it, it had 9 Drakes and 1 Kid Leroy.
Oh,
and
I think I was on the wrong chart then.
Oh,
my bad.
You're just trying to throw Ye a bone. That's very nice of you. You know what I'm saying?
Give Kanye some love.
Give me
my
that
bad
bone back, Kanye.
9 out of 10, okay?
So Kanye's Kanye not on there.
No, Kanye's
man
not on
you
there.
You know, it's better
bad
that he's not, as opposed to just having that one.
That's
against
true
Drake's
good
9.
Good point, Doc.
Believe that. Y'all stick around. Y'all radios, Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
This is Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
Louis G up in here. What up, Lou Dawg?
Netflix with the big announcement, man. Mm. Coming November 5th of this year, Narcos Mexico Season 3.
There are forces moving us, shaping our lives that we're not aware of. My country was at war. A war that would change Mexico and drug trafficking forever. War spreads like fire, but no matter how fast it burns, the music keeps playing.
That's the theme song right there, bro. Amen. Yo,
you're on with this one, man.
Narcos is such,
I'll participate
it's such a big original series that Netflix dropped, bro, man. And it was from the beginning. It was amazing. I can't wait for this season. Obviously, it's pretty much going to leave off or actually begin where Felix Gallardo got arrested. So now it's pretty much like an open Mexico. who's going to be the biggest kingpin now? There's so many people that are arrested. Like,
why don't you go
what cartel's going to come up now? Yo, one of the biggest names that is going to be in this next season, Bad Bunny is in this season.
Oh, really, though?
Yes, Bunnies. Doug.
I don't know how long, because, you know, it is a narco, so I don't know if they're going to kill him off
anytime soon.
But, yeah, he's going to be...
He's going to be dead by page 14.
He's going to be playing Arturo Kitty Paez, a member of the Ramon Arreala Felix's gang, called the Narco Juniors. Yeah, man. That dude is everywhere, bro. What the hell?
Who, Bad Bunny?
Yes,
I know, man.
What the hell?
Good for him.
How much time does he have?
So Bad Bunny is going to play, like, in the Mexican cartel?
Yeah, he's going to be one of the Mexican cartels.
And what nationality is Bad Bunny?
He's Puerto Rican, I believe.
Oh,
Bad Bunny.
Yeah, okay, now Snoop going to come in with a Corona. You know what I'm saying? They're going to be out there on the beach.
Uh-huh. For real, man. But we've talked about, like, me and my friends talk about Narcos all the time, and we love watching it. But like you said, it's one of those things where we've heard about some, like, you know, what are they? The people that cast the locations.
Oh, yeah.
Some of them went missing or died at one
point. Oh, yeah, man.
Because of the filming of this show.
Oh, my God.
Man, I got these interviews called Off Air/Flowers, yeah. Right? And I got one coming out with Edward James Olmos. And we were speaking on American Me. And you know, the scout person, a lot of people, you know, a lot of people got killed on making that movie. And when he was talking about it, dude, I was curling my toes up in my shoes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
This one has to be scary. Like, yeah, I'm going to go to Sinaloa. Oh, you probably shouldn't, bro.
Can we just build out a, you know?
Google Earth this?
Let's just build it out. You know, they did that for the moon landing.
Let's go to Warner real quick.
There it is. Y'all stick around. Y'all radio's Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy. Welcome to Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
Give it up for Ani! Ani is up in here. Yep. Don't try this at home, Ani.
Don't get the medium popcorn when you go to the movie.
I never do.
You don't?
Nah, I weighed 500 pounds. I got it large. I'm so tacky when they give me the large and it's a refill, I dump it into another, like, the little soda bucket.
Oh.
Then I tell them, can you refill this now? Yeah. And sometimes I go to the movies with someone else.
Ooh,
yeah.
No.
Now I'm talking about I eat all that by myself.
Oh, Big, I do the same thing with the box when you get it and start sharing it.
Uh-huh.
But right now they're saying, not right now, but this guy on TikTok, he's like a marketing person.
Oh, Lord,
you know, people went into his LinkedIn, saw where he was working. They're like, you could believe him. But he went on and he showed people, like, hey, these are the three sizes of popcorns. Never get the medium one. And this is why.
This is a marketing trick because the medium popcorn is just driving sales to the large one. By the way, the Pepsi that you drink in cinemas actually doesn't come from Pepsi bottles. They make it on the spot. So you take the water, then you put some gas into it, Pepsi syrup, and you squeeze, put it in gas water, and drink.
Hey, dude, that's everywhere you go. He's ridiculous. It's called the fountain.
Yeah,
the fountain is hooked up to carbonated. It's machines. And they're not sitting there grabbing a water and putting syrup in it and stirring it up and saying, this is yours. Like, no, it's a fountain.
This guy's from the future, Big.
Yeah.
Guys, I was so mind blown. I'm like, what do you mean? That's
anytime you go to a fountain and you push and soda comes out, that's what he was explaining. That it's syrup, and if you look in there, it's a container of syrup. It's the carbonated water. It's made. Because have you ever been and you got it, and it was like, oh, it's just water?
Yeah.
They didn't have the line hooked up, or something was wrong. So this dude.
Even the Coke machines. The Coke machines where you can now pick whatever you want, and there's
like
a bunch of different sodas. Like,
what do you think? So when you get soda from a fountain, what do you think, that there's a Coca-Cola line that's just like a faucet
pouring bottles in the back?
Or there's a little guy in there pouring a can?
Well, not a little guy, but basically like a little guy was like putting it right there. So like they have the bottles of the soda stuff. You just, I really did. I was so
mindful. If you go to McDonald's and you get a Coke.
I always thought they
And it's the machine
with...
right there.
Fountain drinks is what they're going.
So you...
I didn't that make sense.
Yeah. And then also, man, I don't know what it is with inflation of today, but they used to say that a large box of popcorn was like 8 cents worth of kernels.
Damn.
Wow.
Yeah, man. So it's probably what, 10, 15 cents, 20, even if it's a dollar worth of kernels.
Even.
Look at the markup.
It's like $8, $9 zone.
Yeah, man, I'll go get it. Y'all stick around. Y'all radio's Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
You're waking up to Big Boy's Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
Natalia's up in here. Jack Harlow is in the neighborhood news.
Yeah, a few months ago, he was actually featured on a remix from Eminem, his track called Killer, which also featured Cordae. But listen to Jack Harlow's verse and how he mentions Eminem in it.
Yeah, get the money, throw it in the furnace. Yeah, this shit funny, burn it, just to burn it.
swag drip.
I used to rock a toboggan, headphones around my neck, trying to be like Shady. Not a phone that's in my pocket, seem to keep vibrating. I got all these Ronnie Bennett's trying to be my baby, trying to fiance me. I take the steering wheel and drive them girls beyond crazy. I'm on a song with my idol. I'm a cold-blooded version of the song title. I put these diamonds in the ring like they were Shawn Michaels.
Go ahead, boy.
I love it. I love that he, like, he's featured on the remix of it, but also, like, shows so much love to Shady for it. Mm-hmm. But he also revealed something that he says he's waited his whole career for, Big. He was doing an interview recently, and Jack revealed that even though he hasn't had the chance to meet Eminem in person, which is rightfully so. We were in a pandemic. A lot of people aren't doing that sort of thing. You can still work on music together, not physically be in the same spot. But he said that Eminem gave him props. He said, quote, "You're that. You're dope."
That's
he said,
dope.
For him, he's like, that was everything. Just hearing that from someone, the one of the reasons why he's a rapper, what he wanted to do, he looked up to Eminem. And to hear that from your idol, like, oh, my God.
Hey, man, have you ever met Eminem?
No, I'm nervous
too. You met him?
No, I don't think I have.
You say you're nervous
I would be nervous to meet Eminem because I like Eminem so much that I would never want it, like his image, I guess, to be ruined or like him be rude to me or not like me.
Right. Like, hey, man, let me tell you one of the things that happened when I was getting my star. You know, Dr. Dre was doing the presentation.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
And so I'm waiting on the side and everything. And then someone tells me, oh, yeah, they waiting on Dr. They say Eminem is coming too. And I'm like, Eminem's not coming here. You know what I'm saying? Like, Jose told me that. I was like, Jose, stop.
Jose!
Like, dude, Eminem, like, Eminem is not coming nowhere near here.
Who said that, bro?
Some guys, they were and waiting. Then,
but, dude, why would he tell me that? Like, why he couldn't cut the bull right there
before
he told me the way I knew that it wasn't happening? And then, why would you even present that to me as Eminem's coming when it should have been a surprise, which I knew it wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, that's true.
But why would you even come to me and say that?
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying? Like, dude, and you should have known how I cut the bull.
Mm-hmm.
You should have cut the bull before it even came to me. Yeah,
the same guy who dropped your cards on the floor?
Yeah, the same guy.
The same guy who
dropped my speech. You know, low key, he probably next to me because he don't like me.
Yeah.
He's probably the biggest hater and throwing the most sabotage.
To trying to trip you all the time when you're walking.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
We got to follow the money, bro.
There it is.
Somebody's behind it.
Yeah, y'all follow stick around y'all radios, Big Boys Neighborhood.
You're checking out Big Boys Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boys Big Neighborhood, boy. Louis G up in here. What up, Ludo?
Don't tell Mom, Big. All right. But congratulations right now to the newlyweds. That is Cheryl and Kuron McCain, who just tied the knot, Big. Yes, they did tie the knots. And she says that they are deeply in love and have amazing sex.
I'll go ahead now.
Yes,
well,
man.
Congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations to them, man.
All righty.
The only reason I'm talking about it is because Cheryl is 61.
Oh,
and
man.
Kuron
so
is...
you should have said, instead of saying, don't tell mom,
wow.
You should have said, don't tell grandma.
Don't tell grandma.
And how old is her husband?
24 years old.
Oh, my God.
Yes. Oh, they tied the knot finally.
All right. I want to welcome everybody out. If y'all can please move out the way. We need a little more aisle access for her walker and her nursing staff that will be escorting her down.
Where do we put the 17
aisle.
Grandkids?
Yeah, man.
Where do we put her the 17 grandkids at?
Does she have that many grandkids?
17 grandkids. Where
she
do
probably got grandkids that's older than her husband.
So check this out. The way they met was...
They're going on honeymoon to senior world.
Hello.
She eats for $2.65. He gotta pay regular price.
They're deeply in love. They streamed their whole wedding on TikTok.
She only got what a TikTok lot of views. Huh?
I guarantee you, she doesn't.
Yeah,
dude. But
she thought it was a clock website. Yeah, they had her wedding on grandfather clock.
Yeah. It's so weird the way they met. I guess when he was 15, he was working.
He was her nurse
at her son's. At her son's like grocery store that they owned.
So he was 15.
Yeah, so
working at her son's grocery store that the son owned.
Yeah, the son owned. And then eventually when he got older, they rekindled, I guess, and then they fell in love and now they're married. She's 61. Well, you're 24.
She's 61
years old.
Or 64?
61.
61. All right.
You're 24. What are you thinking? Like what's in your head? Are you
Hey man, women do it all
planning?
The time.
Yeah, that's very true.
You're waiting to get in on that grocery store.
For the
You know what I'm saying? He put mirrors under her nose while she sleeps.
taking CPR classes just in case.
Yeah, just in case.
You what kind of life insurance do you pull right away, right?
Hell yeah,
oh,
man.
For sure, man.
Yeah, she got signed scripts from the Golden Girls when she was on there.
And, I wonder if it was a money grab, because it doesn't say anything about like her net worth or anything like
it's
that.
It's love, but Louis.
Well, if her son owns a grocery store, it's got to be something
yeah,
there.
Yeah, right? There has to be some kind of...
No, it could just be love.
Yep. Wait, yeah. What kind of love?
I mean, at 24, yeah. I know I wasn't looking at no 61-year-old woman.
No, now, not at all.
Now, if it was like Oprah or she had some bread, maybe so. You know, believe that.
Hey, but congratulations to Cheryl.
Uh-huh.
In Quran.
All right, y'all stick around. Y'all radios, Big Boys Big Neighborhood.
Boy. You're in Big Boys Neighborhood.
Real 92.3, LA's new home for hip-hop, is standing up against racism and racial injustice in all our communities. Big Boys Neighborhood, Louis G up in here. What up, Lou Dawg?
There's this guy on Reddit, and he's asking if he's a jerk for being fed up that there's constant deaths in his girlfriend's family,
oh,
bro.
Man.
Yo, you know, that's a time, obviously, when someone passes away. Aww. You got to be there for your partner.
Yeah, man.
But when it's 5 to 6 times a year because she has such a large family, this guy says that he's getting fed up with it.
Can't set nothing
because
up.
Because he can't set anything up. He said vacations get ruined. Specific just random weekends that he wants to, you know, do a little getaway or something, get ruined. You really can't plan anything.
He walk in the house and he see his wife on the phone and she wave him off. He's like, oh, man.
Yeah.
And
he says,
man.
It's these like situations where, yeah, once someone dies, it's like days of crying and mourning. And I understand that, but she has such a big family that it's happening 6 times a year. That's a lot to go.
And then it's like, how are you related to this person? Like, did they go to our wedding? No.
Yeah.
When's the last time you seen this person? Okay, so we're flying out to the funeral?
Yeah. Like, so he's your cousin? Are you sure you're no, I've just known him for a long time. So he's not your cousin.
Like, man.
So what is he?
Hey, man, it's nothing like when something gets in the way. And I'm not just saying with death, just anything where it's like, oh, we can't make it. I'm like, oh, man.
Yeah, man, he said every single cousin's birthday, like aunt and uncle's anniversaries, like just minor holidays. Days, just everything, and then
so it's not just death.
No, he said it's just certain things that just mess up.
Oh my God, it's my parents' anniversary.
Yeah,
it's my grandmother's birthday.
Like it's just certain things that are getting annoying, and I would probably get annoyed
Wait
too,
till you
bro.
And Myra get married. You're going to inherit all that, man.
Oh my gosh,
are you
Does
ready
have
for
a big
that?
Family?
No, Myra actually has a small family.
Oh, that's okay. Good.
Surprisingly, bro. Yeah, okay. She has a very small family. Yeah, about like a couple uncles and aunts here and there, but nothing crazy where it's like, oh, we got to go. My family's bigger than her family.
Oh, really, though? So she's probably with her friends. Like, oh, my God.
It's his aunt's birthday.
Girl. Yeah.
It's his uncle's birthday again. Oh, they're doing this, they're doing that. But yeah.
They're having a party for his mom that she doesn't even care about.
Yeah, but is he really a jerk for feeling that way, or is it just something that.
No, I think he's just expressing what is real, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He just saying what was in his head. That's real.
Yeah, people were going in on him. I'm like, man, you should be there. You shouldn't be saying that. What if it happens to your family? But he's like, well, I probably get one person that passes away a year.
Right.
Compared to 7 of them, that's a lot.
Her family get in line a lot.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying?
And that's a whole process where you got to be there for somebody. You know what I mean? Communication with them.
Like
sure
the gatekeeper
okay.
up there, like, damn, another one of y'all? Yeah. All right.
They got their own session.
I heard, you know, like, oh, I'm here. Like, yeah, and you know your cousin Linda be here next week. So you won't be alone for too long. They're all in here. Go on over there. They're all over there.
Table for 12.
In Cabana C. Y'all stick around, y'all radios, Big Boys Neighborhood.
Check this out.
Hey, it is your partner, Big Boy, from Big Boys Neighborhood on iHeartRadio. We have the most fun on your radio. What up, Lou Dawg?
Yo, Big, interesting facts about farts.
On average, people fart 14 times a day. The more, the merrier. The first fart of your day is usually the largest.
The first fart of your day is usually the loudest.
Yeah, come on, guys. I agree with that
hey,
one, man.
Hey, man, I know that people are listening like,
I agree with that
we
one.
We learn so much.
So much.
If you hold in a fart too long, it can be reabsorbed into your blood circulation and breathed out when you exhale.
I know what some of the homies' problems are now. Next time I smell somebody's breath that's bad, I'm going to be like, hey, man, just pass gas, bro. Thank you for listening. It is your partner, Big Boy, Big Boy's Neighborhood. You can catch more of us right here on iHeartRadio. Big Boy's
Big
Neighborhood.
Boy.
Definitely want to thank you guys for hanging out with us in the neighborhood. Appreciate you being here. Thank you for your time. We know that your time is precious, and thank you so much for giving us a little bit of yours. All righty now. For those out there, man, don't judge me.
Yeah, man.
Hey, man, and you know what was crazy? For a lot of the people that called us up and said, don't judge me,
mm-hmm.
I was low-key judging him in my head.
Just a little bit.
Yeah, yeah. You know what I'm saying? You do low-key judge someone.
Yeah, I know.
I'll be at the crib, and I was listening to blues music the other day because, I don't know, I just like blues music.
Yeah.
My sister was like, dude, what are you listening to? I'm like, dude, don't judge me.
Yeah.
Stop it. It's judge my music,
me.
Dude.
Like even some of the clothes that you wear sometimes and how tight your shorts be. I'm not judging you on that.
Hey, don't judge me, man.
I'm not judging you, man. The days you come in with no gel in your hair.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I don't judge you.
Yeah.
The days you come in with gel in your hair.
Don't judge me,
I don't judge you.
There you go,
you know what
bro.
I'm saying?
Thank you.
Hey, man, I remember one time I was in Vegas with our super producer, Jason, right?
Yeah.
And Jason was, you know, a little intoxicated. Mm-hmm. And so when we ordered, I think he ordered like hash browns. Jason, remember? And you was eating them with mustard.
Oh,
and I thought he was so faded that's the way he ate them.
Wow.
Yeah, but he said, no, I eat them like this all
the
time.
Gosh.
But but the way he was eating them, he was like toe up. And he was like... But the crazy thing about it, it was probably like 2 in the morning, 1 in the morning, 2, 3 in the morning. And he was toe up.
Oh, yeah, we were
up.
At the Monte Carlo.
Yeah,
oh, wow.
He was toe down eating. Like,
yes.
And then at 5 o'clock when we had to show up downstairs, he was like, all right, so you got this our table over here. This is this over here. Big, there's a banner right here. We're going to go ahead. They're going to bring down
on
a couple
point.
People. You don't have to interview everyone. Please, such
the
and such.
The show always goes on.
All righty, here we go. We are now live. I was like, this dude.
Hash browns and mustard is a hangover secret, bro.
Hey, man, I was like, dude, that's the cure. Menudo, no. Hash brown and mustard, that is
there it.
But definitely want to thank you guys for hanging out with us, man. Do enjoy the rest of your day. And also, we had T-Pain in the neighborhood for in case you missed it. You can find that entire interview of T-Pain at RadioBigBoy.com. Enjoy the rest of your day. We are Big Boy's Neighborhood, and we are gone.
Big Boy has left the building.
The McDonald's is food you buckle in with your seatbelt deal. And there's no reason not to take that extra precaution. Because a meal from McDonald's is not just a meal. It's often your most precious cargo. Enjoy a tasty double cheeseburger or a six-piece chicken McNuggets for $2 each at any size soft drink like an ice-cold Dr. Pepper for just $1 more. Price and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with combo meal.